Hello everyone, my name is Vikal Jain and today I am going to show you how to set dynamic print area. So what we are going to learn in this video, we are going to learn first we are going to filter our data based on these two criteria and we will generate our report here and we will set a dynamic print area. For example, if we will have 100 rows here, then our printer will print only 100 rows. And if we will have 80 rows here, then our printer will print 80 rows. So it will not extract further reports. So let's begin. For this, we are going to use filter function. You may use advanced filter, but I am going to generate a dynamic report. So I am using filter function, and filter function is available only in Office 365. So filter array would be my raw data. I have already converted my raw data into a table, comma. Now include. So since we are going to find out two criteria, so we are going to use multiply sign. So open the parentheses and this whole column. Now come up. Now equals best, close the parentheses and multiply. Open the parentheses. Now select the name column equals. Now name. So close the parentheses. Why I have taken multiply sign here? Since I am going to filter out both the criteria. If you want to select or criteria means West or Vikal Jain, then you may add it. So I am going to lock it J3 F4 and J3 F4. Now comma. What do you want in case of empty? I want 0. So 0. Close the parentheses and enter. Now see, my report has been filtered out. Now if I am going to change it to Dhanendra, so you can see my report is already updating. So in Dhanendra we have 69 rows and this is not so we are going to set some format here. Date, short date. Now again I am converting this to Vikal Jain and you can see we have 65 rows. Now I am going to count our rows. For that I am going to use count function. So since our filter has made a spell, so I am using my first cell and using hash sign, so it will automatically select my whole data. Close the parentheses and enter. So count has counted only numbers. Instead of count, you may take counta. So I am taking counta here. Now we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 rows. So I am dividing by 6. Now 65 rows we have. Now if we will change our criteria. So 69. Now we are going to use offset function here to set a dynamic print area. Offset. So offset basically helps us to generate a dynamic print area. So what is your reference? Reference is my first serial number, comma, rows. How many rows do you want to switch? I don't want to switch any row. Now how many columns do you want to move? I don't want to move any column. Now what is the height of your data? My data height is 69, comma, and what is your width? What is the width of your data? So 6th column. So if I will press enter, so it will generate same report here. Now I will delete this report. I am just copying it. Now I am setting this data as print area. So page layout, print area and set print area. So my print area has set. Now here is the trick. I am going to use name manager. To open the name manager, you need to click Control F3. Now here it is. Now instead of this, I am using offset function here. Offset. Now I need to lock it. Lock and lock. Okay. I have put two equal signs. Okay. Now my dynamic print area has set. Now let's check. Control P. See, only Janendra data is coming. Now what if I will change this to Vital Jain? Now only Vital Jain data is coming. You may check the length. Length is already became short. So now last thing we need to do here, we need to format border. So for this I am using conditional formatting. I am selecting my data till the end. Now home tab, conditional formatting and new rule, user formula, cell of my data. I am using relative reference. If this does not equal to blanks, then format. So outline would be this one. Okay. Okay. Now my data has set. So what it has done? So if we have 69 rows, so it will format only 69 rows. And if we have only 100 rows, then it will format 100 rows. So I'm changing this to Komal Jain. Now 55 rows, it is only formatting. Now the last thing, we can delete our offset. Now your report is ready. You may use your data validation here to generate this. Now if you will press Control P, so Komal Jain report will only print and it is not taking extra paper, extra ink. So this is the trick, and keep enjoying and keep learning.